Welcome to Aksharasana. In today's class, we are going to find out the relationship between zeros and coefficients of polynomials. See, there is a relationship between the zeros and coefficient. Now, what is a zero of a polynomial? Any value which, when I am going to substitute in the polynomial, if it gives me an answer zero, that is called the zero of the polynomial, right? What is the coefficient of the polynomial? See, I have marked here already. In this polynomial, ax square bx plus c, this a, b and c, these are the coefficients of the polynomial. So there is a relationship between this coefficients and between the zeros of the polynomial, and in today's class we are going to find out that only. So now first you consider alpha and beta be the zeros of the polynomial. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to c, where a is not equal to 0. Why we are saying a is not equal to 0? Supposing when if a is 0, then the whole term will get vanished and you will get only bx plus c. So whenever you talk about a polynomial, you have to say that the leading power, highest power, that term's coefficient should not be equal to 0. That is what you have to keep in mind. So let alpha and beta be zeros of the polynomial. Whenever I say alpha and beta are the zero of the polynomial, immediately what comes to my mind? X minus alpha and X minus beta are the factors of the polynomial. Okay, now ax square plus bx plus c can be written as k into x minus alpha into x minus beta, where k is a constant. Why are we putting this k? See, assume that f of x is equal to 2x square plus 4x plus 6. So what will happen? Everywhere this 2 is common, so I can write it as 2 into x square plus 2x plus 3. See, is it necessary for me to take this 2 also for factorization? No. I need to factorize only this x square plus 2x plus 3. So whenever you are writing a polynomial, you should not take any risk and you have to put a k here. Supposing this k is going to be 1, no problem, you will get x square plus 2x plus 3. Otherwise, you have to include that number also. So only we are putting k here. So k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. I am going to multiply this x minus alpha into x minus beta. I know the identity, x minus a into x minus b is equal to x square minus x into a plus b plus ab. You have studied an identity in 9th standard. Use this identity, you will get x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Now what I'll do, I'll multiply everything with k, so I'll get k x square minus k into alpha plus beta into x plus k into alpha beta. Okay, now what will happen? Here I am having ax square plus bx plus c, and this side I am having all these terms. I am going to compare both sides. What is comparison? I am going to take the coefficient of x square on both sides and put they are equal. So when I am comparing the coefficient of x square, I will get a is equal to k. When I compare the coefficient of x, I will get minus k into alpha plus beta is b. See, I have marked it with the same color, k, a. Minus k into alpha plus beta is b. K alpha beta is c. So c is equal to plus k into alpha beta. Now what I can do? B is equal to minus k into alpha plus beta. But I know a is equal to k. So I will put b is equal to minus a into alpha plus beta, which implies alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. This a will come in the denominator. So alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Similarly, I know c is equal to k into alpha plus beta. Okay, what is this k? This k is nothing but k. So instead of k, I will put a into alpha beta. Therefore, alpha beta is equal to plus c by a. Now I have found out alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a and alpha beta is equal to c by a. Now I have f of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Alpha beta is c by a. Now what is this alpha plus beta? Alpha is one of the zero and beta is another zero. So my alpha plus beta is nothing but sum of zeros. which I will call it as SOZ. So SOZ is equal to minus B by A. What is this minus B? What is this B? This B is the coefficient of X. So B is minus coefficient of X and A is coefficient of X square. So what we are getting? Sum of the zeros. What is sum of the zeros? Alpha plus beta. So alpha plus beta is equal to minus coefficient of X by coefficient of X square. So the relationship between the zeros, the sum of the zeros is related with the coefficient of this polynomial as minus coefficient of X by coefficient of X square. Similarly, alpha beta you can write alpha into beta. What is this? Product of zeros. Product of zeros is POZ. We will say POZ is equal to, we have found out alpha into beta as C by A. Now what is C? C is a constant term. So constant term divided by coefficient of X square. So now the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient of the polynomial is nothing but SOZ. Sum of the zeros is equal to minus B by A and POZ is equal to C by A. This is the relationship. So you will be given problem in this, which will ask you to find out the relationship. You have to establish the relationship between the zeros. So you have to find out the zeros of the polynomial, add them and find out the answer. And then again using the coefficient you have to find out, and you have to say both are equal.